just left the Threadbull on New Year's Eve. It is. And we're going to go out camping and meet up with our friends in the Victorian High Country. So we've got about a 4-hour drive.
Yep.
To get there, and now we're going through the beautiful alpine forest. We're still in New South Wales, but we will eventually make our way down to Victoria. We've left Bright and we're getting close to Mount Hotham. We're on the Great Alpine Ride in Victoria and we are just having a stop at Blowhard Hut, a very, very windy area normally, but today actually we have beautiful, beautiful sunny weather, about 25 degrees up here. Down the valley it was about 33, so it's been a bit of a climb for the good old beast to get up here, and all the mountains are in the background. Quite steep windy alpine road to get through.
If I wrote you a song, if I got every word perfectly weighted on a thin piece of paper.
We just had a drink at the Dogo Hotel. Filled up some diesel and then we're gonna go camping.
We're just having a little bit of rain. We thought it wasn't going to come in, so we didn't prepare. But now we're getting a fair bit.
Well, we have a pretty sweet setup in here.
We've got a good setup, and luckily we put the awning out just minutes before the rain came.
Perfectly weighted on a thin piece of paper. Would it make any difference? Would it change for the better if I wrote you a poem, if I posted a letter?
Sure, our cars don't float when we drive in here.
It looks pretty deep, eh?
Yeah. It could be.
Yeah, I reckon check that hole to the right there. Yeah.
I think
you
made the right decision. What a pretty hard bottom.
Yeah, it's fun.
Getting deeper.
You don't want to go there.
Down into the left of, there's a white rock that you'll see in the middle of the town, around that. And then we'll keep going and there'll be another one very shortly.
Okay.
That was cool.
Too easy.
Too easy.
Second creek crossing for this trip. We just got to be careful with our bikes at the back. So we got a big, like a mud hole here.
Maybe check my feet on this. On this hole.
Good setup, Max.
Could be the best one. Yeah, this one. The fire.
Did you see that? Is it me? Down a bit of a steep section. We've got the bikes at the back, but we figured out we get the reverse camera on so we can see if they touch on the dippers. Starting our drive on the Billy Goat Bluff track. It's very steep.
Fred and Lou coming up in the big cruiser. Disco parked up. We're heading up there next. Listen to the big yell. Easy. Too easy.
There's only one or two washout pits to this, but you'd pick your line, you'd go straight over the top of them.
The GoPro inside for this bit because it's going to be a bit bouncy. It's hectic.
Rocky. Sharp rocks. Bad. She's good.
Having a little pit stop and a chat. It was quite a hectic section there, and I think Max got a bit of tire damage, but we're all good and we're going to continue to climb. To meet traffic, but it's doable.
Supposed to do.
back, then when you're ready. Pretty good campsite.
Max, so much going on here?
Well, we're doing some wood splitting. I bought the big one for this trip. Just give me a couple minutes. If you're in a bit of a rush because there's a bit of a storm coming over, what you want to do is get your axe and just fuck it off over there and then use your chainsaw.
I don't think Dutch oven operator.
Dutch oven operator.
Swedish torch. Wow. Hand cut as well.
Yeah. With men, knife and fork?
Yep. Men just cutting it with our Victorinox belt mounted saws. Small Victorinox belt mounted saw.
Got the Swedish Dutch oven.
Steamed hams on the go.
Look at that. Hot
perfectly weighted on a thin piece of paper.